point of talking about pivot matrices was to have an elegant way of describing what we're going to call LU factorization with partial pivoting, and we're going to describe a specific algorithm for computing that. Namely, we're going to modify the right-looking algorithm that we started with. Remember, that's the algorithm that was equivalent to Gaussian elimination. So let's say that we've gotten to this point in the algorithm where we've already processed the first columns, and now we're going to work with the current column. We've introduced zeros below the diagonal to the left of this line. And if alpha 1, 1 now is equal to 0, we clearly have a problem if we don't do something, because we'll end up dividing by 0. But already, if alpha 1, 1 is small in magnitude, we have a problem. And why that's a problem, we'll talk about a little bit later. So, since we want to avoid having an element that is small in magnitude relative to the entries below it, the safest thing to do is to find the element that has maximal magnitude among these entries right here, and to then move that entry to the top, which then of course means moving the entire row into that position. So what do? You look at this vector right here, you figure out what the entry is of maximal magnitude, what the index is, and then you use that to pivot this matrix. And if we say pi 1 is the index of the entry relative to the first entry in this vector right here that is maximal magnitude, then this matrix will swap the appropriate rows. All right? Now, that then leaves us with a matrix that looks like this, where now we can look at that entry and we can compute the Gauss transform that places the zeros right here. That Gauss transform would look something like this. And when you then apply that to this matrix, then it introduces zeros right there and subtracts a rank 1 update from matrix A22 tilde. Now, if we say this is equal to this is equal to this, then we're a little bit off, because you really want to then see that this Gauss transform in effect also has to be applied to whatever we started with. So here we need to say the identity 1 minus L21 identity. And now we indeed have that this is equal to this is equal to this. Right? How do we incorporate that into our right-looking algorithm that we already had created before? Well, notice that we want to keep track of this vector of integers that tells us which rows to pivot, which rows to swap. So we introduce a vector p that keeps track of these, and we partition and repartition that vector so that we expose pi 1 at the appropriate moment. We then need to compute the index of the element with maximal magnitude. We then want to swap the appropriate rows, and here notice that we're not only swapping the two rows that we talked about right here, but we're actually also swapping the multipliers that were computed in previous iterations. And that turns out to be very important in order to end up with an LU factorization with matrix A as if it had been pre-permuted. We'll talk about that in a second. And then once we have done that, all we need to do is compute the multipliers, do the rank 1 update, and move on.